Chancellor of Cooperation Al-Islam and Muhammadiyah and Digitalization of University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya, the Honorable Mr. Pramudana Ihsan, as whom MPD as Head of International Affairs and Cooperation of University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya, the Honorable Deputy Dean One, Mrs. Dewi Ilma Antawati, SPSC, MPSE Psikolog, Deputy Dean Two, Mrs. Fedi Kosiana, SPSC, MPSE Psikolog, and the Head of Program Study, Mrs. Hedi Murdiani, MPSE, MKES, and all the lecturer at a psychology faculty in University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya. And I'm proud of all students on online course in Mental Health Faculty of Psychology in University Muhammadiyah Surabaya. Alhamdulillah wa syukurillah wa la hawla wa la quwata illa billah alil azim. Greeting to all attendants. In the morning, I'm so happy. This mental health online course is one form of implementation of the independent campus learning program of the Minister of Education and Culture of Republic Indonesia, namely a student exchange. So we carry out an international student exchange program. The theme of the online course is mental health, in particular, building healthy relationship in digital life based on the fact that in this modern era, we all can be separate from advanced technology device with digital system. There must be gap, there are obstacles, there are problems that arise due to change in digital technology, which will result in disruption of mental health. So we hope that from this online course, the participant gain knowledge about how to build healthy relationship in digital era so that they can to be applied in their personal life so that they become prosperous individuals and also to help people around them who have mental health problems so that a well-being society building. And then we report the number of online course participants as many as 17 students. There are from Algeria, Cambodia, Sudan, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan and Indonesia. And then I want to attend each participant one by one. Kamelia Hajar Abdul Karim. Bisa diperlihatkan? Nama itu Usaimah Ahmad Nizam, Vivit Rohmania, Kuha Fesah Rongso, Mr. Abdul Sukodina Sukadina, Amili Zing Ying Tan, Salsa Bila Nule, Taline Mahbin, Betty Susanti, Muhammad Hudai Berdiev, parinya aumasa mongkuntea Mohmed Gesmala El Hadfa Khalifa Labed Mirat Budaya Berdiev Zulmakul Anarbek Kisi Muhammad Kuliah. Finally, for all students, welcome to join the Faculty of Psychology, University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya. We hope that all of you will follow this entire series of online course until 9 meeting and the knowledge gain is beneficial for both yourself and those around you. Thank you so much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ladies and gentlemen, next, let's follow the delivery of speech by Mr. Pramudana Ihsan as HUM MPD as Head of International Affairs and Cooperation of University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya. The screen is yours.
Hey, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Honorable Vice Rector for Dr. Mudzakir Askep Nurse MCup and Honorable the Dean of Psychology, we have Bu Wiwi Juwarini Prihastiwi, and also Vice Deans, we have Bu Dewi Ilma, and we have the Head of Department from the Psychology, we Bu Hetty Murdiani, and all the lecturers whom I respect. Do not forget that I need to also convey my biggest gratitude to all of the committees and also participants, because without you all, this event cannot be run smoothly. That's the first I would like to convey. Second of all, this event has been run because each department now has its own obligation to run international class. And based on that information, International Office and Partnership Universitas Muhammadiyah Surabaya provide an aid to make it happen. And Alhamdulillah, this event is now open by the Vice Rector 4 of Universitas Muhammadiyah Surabaya. I would like to convey my apology because some of the participants, I already called them, they are still in the process of sleeping. They are still sleeping, some of them. But I would like to force some of them to join afterwards. After this, I'm going to call one by one again. The last, hopefully this can be beneficial to the Department of Psychology. This can increase and boost the confidence of psychology department students. And also this can give a great atmosphere to the lecturers of psychology department in Universitas Muhammadiyah Surabaya. Because whether we like it or not, in this era of globalization and digitization, we cannot undo the process of teaching not only in our own campus, but we are also teaching those who are not registered in campus regularly. And also in the next future, it also boosts confidence to the lecturers to teach in different universities. So be ready with that chance. In the near future, we are going to arrange that. I think that's all from me. Thank you very much. Hopefully, you can join starting the beginning until the end and you get what you are expecting to have. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning to all of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, then let us follow the delivery of remarks as well as opening the event. Dr. Mundakir S. Cup, Nurse M. Cup, as Vice Director of Digitalization and the International Affairs University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya, as well as in the course. The screen is yours.
Oh, okay, thank you. Is my sound clear?
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay.
Clear.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa syukrulillah, la hawla wa la quwata illa billah, asyadu ala ilaha illallah, waqtahu la syarikalah, wa asyadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh la nabiya ba'da. The Honorable Dean of Faculty of Psychology and also all Vice Dean, the Honorable Head of International Office, the distinguished all speaker, the distinguished head of psychology program, and also all lecturer, the distinguished committee, and all participants from Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand, Turkmenistan, Cambodia, Sudan, Algeria, Kyrgyzstan, and also from Indonesia student, which I am proud of you all. Thanks for joining this event. First of all, I would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us mercy and blessing until we can attend this course. Secondly, my salawat and salam be with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Peace be upon him who has guided us from the darkness to lightness in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give some view on this mental health problem in the perspective of the COVID-19 pandemic era and the digital era. Devora Kestel, Director of the World Health Organization, Department of Mental Health and Drug User, warned of the possible increase in the number and severity of mental illness due to the COVID-19 pandemic. In line with Devora Kestel statement, the COVID-19 Task Force report shows that this pandemic has resulted in 80% of psychological problems and the rest in physical health problem. This means that the government should be more attention to mental health issues, and also we as a Muhammadiyah organization. Based on a mental health survey through online self-examination conducted by the Association of Indonesian Mental Medicine Specialists, or PDSKJI in Indonesia, on 1,552 respondents regarding anxiety, depression, and trauma, so that 63% of respondents experience anxiety, and 66% of respondents experience depression due to the COVID-19 pandemic. 46% of respondents experience severe post-traumatic psychological stress symptom, and 33% experience moderate symptom. Ladies and gentlemen, the COVID-19 pandemic is new source of stress for the world community today. Globally, there are 4 main risk factors for depression due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The first social distancing and isolation. For example, a Chinese student in Saudi Arabia committed suicide after being isolated in the hospital because he was suspected of being infected with COVID-19. Second, economic recession. The COVID-19 pandemic has triggered a global economic crisis that is likely to increase the risk of occupational and economic suicide. In Germany, for example, the Ministry of Finance committed suicide at the end of March 2020. Out of despair about the impact of COVID-19 on the German economy. In Indonesia, until July 31, 2020, the Ministry of Manpower recorded that 2.14 million formal and informal workers were affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. The third factor, stress and trauma to health workers. Healthcare providers have the highest mental health risk during the COVID-19 pandemic. The stress comes from extreme stress, fear of contracting COVID, feelings of helplessness, and trauma from seeing COVID-19 patients who die alone. This factor lead to the risk of suicide for the health worker. The last factor, stigma and discrimination. The stigma of COVID-19 can trigger suicide around the world. In India, for example, a man committed suicide after experiencing a social boycott and religious discrimination of suspicion of being infected with COVID-19. In Bangladesh, a man killed himself after being isolated by a neighbor after being diagnosed with COVID-19. And in Indonesia, health worker experienced stigma and discrimination. The nurse and their families are excluded from the social environment, evicted, prohibited from taking public transportation, prohibited from getting married, and possibly divorced. Ladies and gentlemen, regarding this factor, digitalization provides an alternative solution for how to connect friends, families, and others, leading to maintain social emotional relationship with positively benefit to our mental health. This situation may create new trend from face-to-face connection to virtual connection. For this reason, I appreciate Dean and the committee that took the theme of mental health, building healthy relationship in digitalized life in this course. Therefore, I would like to sincerely thank all speakers for your generosity to share your knowledge and experiences in this event. We appreciate your valuable contribution and hope that this the first step in implementing international class program in the future. I would also like to extend my thanks to International Office, Pak Pram, and committees to prepare and make this virtual course happen for the participants. I hope you enjoy this course and thank you for your active participation. Lastly, before I end my speech with the hope that this event will be smooth and successful and useful for all. Let's open it together by reading Basmalah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Thank you so much. Nasru minallah wa fatun qarib wa basyiril mu'minin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
And gentlemen, so that our event is given the grace and blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let us follow the reading of the prayer that will be brought by Sofi Hidayatul Ummah.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam.
Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrofil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbihi ajmain. Ya Allah, Tuhan yang Maha Penyayang, hanya rahmat dan kasih sayang-Mu-lah sehingga segala aktivitas kami dalam acara ini berjalan dengan lancar walaupun menguras waktu, tenaga dan pikiran. Dan hari ini ya Allah, kami berkumpul di tempat ini memanjatkan puji syukur kepada-Mu sekaligus menutup kegiatan kami. Ya Allah, berkailah segala aktivitas kami selama dalam mengikuti rangkaian acara kami dan jadikanlah sebagai amal ibadah di sisi-Mu. Untuk itu, ya Allah, tetapkanlah rahmat dan kasih sayang-Mu kepada kami dan jadikanlah pertemuan ini sebagai pertemuan yang Engkau ridhoi. Allahumma la sahla illa ma ja'alahu sahla. Ya Allah, mudahkanlah segala urusan kami, karena tidak ada yang mudah kecuali Engkau. Jadikan mudah. Allahumma ftaha alaina abwaabal khair, wa abwaabal barakah, wa abwaabal ni'mah, wa abwaabal rizki, wa abwaabal quwwati, wa abwaabal suhati, wa abwaabal salamati birahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Ya Allah, bukakanlah atas kami pintu kebajikan, pintu berkah, pintu rahmat, pintu kekuatan, pintu rezeki, pintu kesehatan, pintu keselamatan. Karena hanya Engkaulah yang Maha Pengasih dan Maha Penyayang. Allahumma inna ta'udzubika min hammi wal huzni wa a'udzubika minal ajari minal ajazi wal kasli. Ya Allah, kami berlindung kepada-Mu dari keraguan-keraguan hati dan duka cita, dan kami berlindung kepada-Mu dari sifat lemah dan malas. Rabbana afrigh alaina sabran wa tsabbit aqdamana. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adzaban nar. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun 'alal mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Ya Allah, curahkanlah kesabaran atas kami dan teguhkanlah pendirian kami terhadap cobaan dan kebenaran. Ya Allah, berkailah semua ilmu yang kami dapat selama kegiatan ini, sehingga kami dapat mengamalkan setelah kami bubar dan ke rumah masing-masing. Sehingga kami bisa menjadi suri tauladan dalam keluarga, masyarakat, bangsa, dan negara. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, asyhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
And gentlemen, that's the whole series of opening ceremonies we have followed together. Let us close this opening ceremony by saying hamdalah. Next, let us listen together general lecture by Dr. Andawi Juarini Prihastiwi MC with the theme Mental Health in Digital Age, followed with some information about the course. The screen is yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ladies and gentlemen, all the lecturer participant, satu kehormatan bagi saya diberi kesempatan untuk menyampaikan materi di awal pembukaan ini. I think that I present today is more currently referred to as an introduction lecture, but not general lecture. Because my material is not an in-depth analysis. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Mental health and digital life. For all the lecture participants, still have spirits? I hope you have still have spirits.
Spirited.
Okay. Okay, the picture, I think the activities of current, the third millennial generations. Yeah. The picture of the activity of current generation facing each other but not communicating with each other. Technological development are growing rapidly with mark the industrial era 4.0 and mastery of technology is prestige and an indicator of a country progress. A country is said to be advanced if it has a high level of mastery of technology, while country that not adapted to technological advance are often referred to as failed country. Related to technology development, there are research conducts by Zogby International in the United States to 2 billion respondents when asked their prediction about future information technology. 40% respondent imagine that in the next few years, a chip will be planted in the body of all citizens of the world. Chip. Yeah. I think it is a target in 20 and 24 years. This chip serves to monitor health condition and detect presence of the person. So, this one example for my happen to us on the development of technology, where the chip will be used to monitor our movement. Yeah, the detail we have did such as ID card number, password, password ATM, yeah, or email password, and so on, will be known to many people, which might also be missed. Yeah. Saya sangat khawatir tentang hal ini. Saya kira mungkin semua juga akan khawatir kalau ini terjadi. Ya, oleh karena itu banyak ada beberapa orang yang tidak mau divaksin karena menganggap vaksin itu dimasuki chip. Ya, sehingga apa yang terjadi dalam diri kita itu bisa diketahui oleh semua orang. Dan saya kira sekarang juga I'm sorry, so Indonesian language. Saya kira kita juga paham ketika medsos bisa tahu pikiran kita, tahu kebutuhan kita. Ketika kita searching in Google one item, maka kemudian muncul di media sosial yang kita punya item yang kita cari itu. Ya. Technological development that have an impact on modernization, this can be seen that the development of information technology, is experiencing the fastest development. So, massive use of digital technology in education, in industry, and commerce, health, individual, bank, so on. In the 2020, internet user in Indonesia reached 202 million people, or 73% of total population, so that Indonesia occupies the position of fourth largest internet user country. So, bisa kita ketahui begitu hampir 100% dari populasi Indonesia sudah menggunakan internet. Digital technology has made all kind of media fused into the entire life of women. Mode reading, listening, watching in media is no longer with the separate, but technically it is all together and the more freely in the grip of a man who always moving. Like mobile phone. In the past, watching activities on TV, communicating by telephone cable, listening through the radio, but not all the activities are carried out on one big device, yaitu mobile phone. Internet and mobile phone have come commonplace feature of modern life. So like globalization and the world in palm of your hand. Jadi dunia ini sudah berada di genggaman saudara. Kalau tadi dikemukakan bahwa develop of information technology is fast development. So kita tahu banyak sekali media massa like Twitter, Instagram, kemudian Facebook, YouTube, TikTok. TikTok is trending now. Yeah, like apa ya P itu, like Telegram and so on. Everyone must have at least one sosmed. I like seperti saya, I have 4 sosmed, ya, WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. Saya kira semua juga memiliki sosial media tersebut. Nah, and then perkembangan digital, teknologi digital have the positive side of digital technology, fast data flow, efficiency, increase productivity, real time convenience. I think positive side ini example in this online course yang sekarang kita lalui, the participant don't need to come to Indonesia but can still attend lectures so they are cost efficient, can be real time. I think in Thailand akan bisa diikuti di negara Thailand di waktu yang sama. Can be real time between Surabaya, Sudan, Malaysia, Turkmenistan, Turkmenistan, Thailand in second. And then this material can be received by participant even though very far away. Efficiency, real time, increase productivity juga dilihat sebagai example. We no longer have to go to store because our finger are able to make transaction through e-commerce and to do financial transaction while lying down at home. Jadi kita bisa saja dengan berlayah-layah di rumah, kita bisa membeli sesuatu, bisa melakukan transaksi bank hanya menggunakan jari kita. Tapi ada juga di sini efek yang lain. The flow of data very quickly lead to a lot of people who are not able to filter the message you receive. So unconsciously, that information had gradually effect pattern of behavior and culture in community. Jadi kita seringkali tidak pernah mampu memfilter message yang kita terima, sehingga itu akan mempengaruhi pola-pola perilaku dan budaya di masyarakat. So, the flow of data, the flow of data bring every culture of the world closer to one another. As a result, the interaction of every culture and the world with other culture increase. Itu disebut dengan globalisasi. Ini adalah satu pendapat bahwa isi di dalam internet dan juga mungkin di medsos itu tidak ada editor eksternal, tidak ada reviewer. There are no editor or external reviewer who evaluate the content to determine whether it should be published or not. Ya. Jadi apa yang ada di internet banyak yang tidak ada yang melakukan review, melakukan tidak ada editor sehingga semua all information can publish in internet. Oleh karena itu, everyone with the basic skill necessary to create and maintain a website can post information. The accuracy, quality of that information is not guaranteed, like in resources except science journal. Kecuali di jurnal ilmiah yang bisa dipertanggungjawabkan isi dari apa yang dipublis. Kalau dampak dari teknologi berdampak pada perubahan budaya, culture change. Saya beri contoh, I give a example. In Indonesian people who have a more close Eastern culture, there are personal area that are private that are not seen by others. So now everything can be open to social media, include uploading household problem on social media. Jadi kalau they have conflict with her husband, so uploading in social media. Culture change, lifestyle change, ya. Saya kira perubahan-perubahan gaya hidup kita, ya, lebih ke materi, ya. Jadi materi oriented, ya, hedonis. Karena begitu banyak hal yang ditawarkan melalui media massa. Behavior change, in the past, student in completing a science paper no longer had to come to the library. The student's table has full a pile of books. Nowadays, it's enough to bring a laptop because all references have been converted into digital form. The important thing that is there are electricity and internet network. Number two, reduce face-to-face interaction. Its family member is busy with a smartphone, so they are no longer communicate face to face. Lalu bagaimana semua itu berdampak pada all the effect in mental health disorder? Number one is stress. So much information that goes into our social media. So many events are held online, so we have to attend 3 or more activities in the same time. And there are a survey on social media users in Australia found that a constant checker, constant checkers are those who frequently view social media updates and get notifications passed to their phone, report greater overall stress than adults who check list often. Jadi sering kita mengecek media sosial yang kita punya, sering mengecek notifikasi, itu membuat lebih stres, ya, lebih besar stresnya pada daripada orang dewasa yang kurang begitu sering mengecek sosial media. Research also suggests that if receiving constant email notification reduce productivity, while limiting email checks to 3 times a day lower stress and increase well-being. Saya kira ini semua kita alami. Ya. Jadi seringkali waktu kita habis, kita tidak produktif hanya karena mengecek dari sosial media. Number 2, nomophobia. Nomophobia, which is a feeling of anxiety and fear when not with a cell phone atau mobile phone. Based on survey conducted by Secure Envoy, and 1 million people in UK, it was found that ...66% had nomophobia. Yeah. Dan semakin meningkat usia, semakin meningkat pula mengalami nomophobia. Yeah. Number 3... mental health disorder, antisosial, like cyberbullying. Yeah. Indonesian Child Protection Committee note that in the period of 9 years, from 2011 to 2019, reported case of bullying in both education and social media, the number reached 2,423 reports, and the trend continues to increase. I think case of the bullying are the iceberg. Many cases go unreported. And then sexual grooming can happen in online space as well as in person by a stranger or someone known. It involves to offender building a relationship with a child. The process of grooming can take place in a matter and minutes over one conversation or over long period of time. in some cases hears. The aim of sexual grooming is to abuse and exploit in two ways: online sexual abuse and physical meeting. Yeah. To meet them face to face, to order to abuse them. Grooming is also used by offender with the aim of other form abuse, such as criminal exploitation or trafficking children. An Indonesian national police reported that there are 2,036 child grooming case occurring sampai tahun 2019. Yeah, I think cases of bullying, sexual grooming are the iceberg too. Many cases go unreported. Itulah beberapa many example mental health disorder. So, what is mental health in digital life? Mental health is our emotional, psychological, and social well-being. Mental health does not only affect the way we think, feel, and act, but also how we handle stress related to others and make choice. I think religion harus menjadi must to pegangan, ya, harus menjadi pegangan, ya. Religion must be the guide of life. All our thought and behavior must be based on religion values, so that behavior on the right path, right track, right path. What is the connection between mental health and Islam? Number one is very important, is spiritual resiliency. Semua kita harus memiliki spiritual resiliency. We all have to spiritual resiliency. Islam offer a spiritual sanctuary for Muslim to live a peaceful life by using their inner strength and having a strong relationship with the ultimate power, is Allah. Being optimistic, purifying their feeling, and not waiting for outside even to improve. The spiritual status as an interior power can be exercised to have a calm mind, healthy consciousness, and positive thought. Number two, the role of patience. Islam plays great importance on patience. Patience is a virtue that enables the individual to process toward a forty goal unaffected by adverse circumstance or repeated provocation. So I want to give tips how to we harness technology to boost well-being and create a healthy digital life. Number one, checklist notification and reduce viewing social media update. Yeah, I think ketika kita sering melakukan check notification, maka membuat kita stres. Ya, tadi I think like this recent survey social media user in Australia. Yeah, found that constant check forms yeah, report greater overall stress than adult who check list often. So we must check list notification and reduce viewing social media update. Number two, take care when posting. Think about the impact of your online behavior on your own and other health, and do you bid to create a positive online social environment? Jadi harus kita pikirkan matang-matang apa yang kita akan posting, karena apa yang kita posting akan berdampak pada diri kita, perilaku kita, juga perilaku orang lain, dan kesehatan mental orang lain. Number three, take an activity rule. Passive use of social media often lead to increased stress. Social comparison and envy. So it is a mental health disorder, I think. But being an active, constructive, and respectful contributor has been shown to have mental health benefit by building positive social connection. Seek out social connection that boosts your well-being rather than undermine. Block the bullies. Ya, jadi kita block saja mereka yang selalu membuli. Ya, baik membuli fisik maupun psikologis. Ya, bully fisik itu body shaming maupun bully psikologis. Selanjutnya, set boundaries around words. Nah, ini. Constant access to work-related email and other social media increase the risk of never actually quitting work. And this can result in work problems spilling over into family time and can affect other aspects of health. Stress. Jadi mungkin ini yang kita alami ya ketika semua menggunakan digital, bekerja itu 24 jam. We our work until 24 time. Okay. Connected offline. Nah, individual who mindfully engage with people and connect with their environment are healthier and enjoy a greater sense of well-being. So, oleh karena itu acara ini diselenggarakan ya, bagaimana membangun hubungan yang sehat di era digital ini. And the last, we have spiritual relationship. Okay. I think the discussion material that I can convey might be useful. And so I'm so sorry because not fluent in English, speak English. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, kelas. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
I want to inform you about this class. Maybe most of you have already know me, but some of you haven't. I am Dewi Irma Antawati. And I am Bu Hetty. Bu Hetty, please show your face, please. This is Bu Hetty. And Mas Isa, as the staff of the faculty, will help you to the rest of this course. So I will share the schedule of this course. Okay, this course will be held every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Friday in at 9:30 until 11:20. And every Saturday and Sunday at 10 and 11:40 Indonesian time, West Indonesian time. Maybe the yes. Student from outside Indonesia maybe have already know that Indonesia have 3 time zone. We are University of Muhammadiyah Surabaya is in West Indonesian time zone. So maybe you can check the time zone with your country time zone. So we'll put this class will be scheduled in this day, yeah, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And for student from other countries, maybe you can see the list in the screen. You already have a registration number. This is your registration number. Yeah, you can use this registration number to enter the e-learning that we will use for learning management system, yeah, for this class. I will show you the learning management system, what it looks like. So this is our learning management system. You can use that registration number to log in to this LMS, yeah, this e-learning. You can enter your registration number as username and as password. Okay. Maybe perkenalan.
Introduction.
Introduction. We for the of this class, or we can introduce ourselves in the
no.
Class, yeah.
introduce in class each person masing-masing.
Ya, yeah, oke. Okay. Untuk mahasiswa internal yang namanya belum masuk e-learning nanti akan dimasukkan ya, karena yang baru daftar kemarin nanti akan dimasukkan ke dalam e-learning NIM-nya. Jadi nanti akan masuk di e-learning masing-masing untuk online course ini. Oke, okay, maybe apakah semua sudah masuk ke dalam grup WhatsApp? Does anyone here already join WhatsApp group?
Sudah join, Bu.
Join. Okay, if you haven't joined WhatsApp group, the staff Mas Isa will inform you the link, and you can join the WhatsApp group to get information about this class. Okay, I think that's enough for today. See you again in class. Thank you very much for your participation. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.
Halo Bu Betty, sudah vaksin?
Sampun Bu.
Nggak foto dulu Bu Ilma.
Oh iya.
Yeah.
Let's take a picture together.
Let's take the picture together.
Bu Fethi yang memotongnya biasanya.
Gak bisa digedein, Bu. Bu, di tempat saya gak bisa digedein. Ini apa? View, oh sorry, gallery. Oke. Silakan Anda open cam dulu. Kita take a picture for a while.
Okay, everyone, open your cam.
Please open your cam.
Give your best smile.
Okay, ready? Please, 1, 2, 3. Okay, thank you. I will share this picture on our group.
Second page.
Second phase. Okay. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ya Allah.
Gentlemen, that is our series of events during the day. Thank you for your participation. As the host of the event, I apologize if any words are less pleasing. Akhiru qawli hadha. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih.
See you tomorrow, Bu Betty.
Thank you Bu Betty and all.
Terima kasih.
Bu Betty have already get her vaccination today.